everyone, this is Yanis Makula, member of the Spellbar Indoors design team. In this video, I'm sharing a simple Love You card featuring a new sapphire die cutting and embossing machine from Spellbinders, as well as new hearts and flowers dies. Begin working on your project by creating a top folding 4.25 by 5.5 inches card base out of white cardstock and cover the entire front panel of the card with patterned paper of your choice. Make sure to add double-sided adhesive along all four sides of your card base and also a bit in the center. Next, adhere your patterned paper and trim the excess using scissors or your paper trimmer. Now let's create a few die-cut and embossed elements for our project. Place your sapphire die-cutting and embossing machine onto your table and pull down trays on both sides of the machine to be able to feed the cutting and embossing sandwiches through, and also select the dies you want to use. I'm going to be doing some die-cutting first, so I will only need the white A base plate and the gray C cutting plate. Begin by placing the beautiful doily die onto light peach paper. Make sure the pretty side of the paper is facing up and the die is being placed cutting edge down. Next, use a small piece of low-tech tape, such as washi tape, painter's tape, or even a simple post-it note, to affix the die in place. Since I still have some room there on my light peach paper, I'm going to place one more die there, a large solid flower, to cut both at once and save myself some time. So after placing the second die there and placing this onto a gray C cutting plate, I still have some room there for more dies. I'm using gold cardstock this time and using the large open flower, a small flower, and a small leaf. So now that I have my dies taped to the paper, I'm going to build my cutting sandwich. I have the C gray cutting plate on the bottom, next my paper facing pretty side up, my dies facing cutting edge down, and finally the white A base plate. Now go ahead and send this through the sapphire die cutting and embossing machine. Make sure to hold the machine with one hand and turn the handle with the other. The sandwich will pop out on the other side. It's time to add some beautiful detail to those pieces and emboss them. Before we do any embossing, I like to remove washi tape from the dies and from the paper. Some tapes might be too sticky and might be too difficult to remove after the piece has been embossed. So simply make sure to remove the tape both from the paper and from the die before you emboss it. You can choose to keep or remove the negative die cut piece, it really doesn't matter. In some cases, negative pieces might also be used as a fun element on a project. Do, however, make sure to keep the die cut piece in the die for embossing. Place your die with your paper still being inside onto an A white base plate. Make sure the die is facing cutting edge up. Cover with tan embossing mat and with blue embossing plate, and once again send this through the machine. If you find it difficult to insert the plates into the machine, slide the dies about 1/2 inch away from the edge, cover with tan embossing mat and blue embossing plate, and try again. Use a Spellbinders 2-in-1 to help you pop the die cuts from the dies and also to clean the dies from the little negative pieces that might still remain in the die after cutting. So here are all the cut and embossed elements that we will be needing for this project. Here's a large gold open flower, 3 gold leaves, next 2 small gold flowers, 1 large peach doily, and 1 large flower. Notice that the large solid and open flowers go well together. You can place the open one on top of the solid one and create a beautiful layered piece. And the small flowers fit perfectly on top of the doily. And by using 2 different colors of cardstock, you can easily create some fun and really beautiful embellishments for your project. Now go ahead and use some liquid glue and adhere the gold open flower on top of the large peach flower and do the same with the small gold flowers and the doily. I've placed 2 clear blocks on top of my flower to apply some pressure and make sure they adhere well. And now I'm going to add the second small flower onto my doily, making sure I leave some room there for the large flower. While glue is drying, I'm going to work on a sentiment for this project. I'm using a clear sentiment stamp and a brown ink and stamping a simple "Love you, always have, always will" onto a piece of light peach paper. I've added some double-sided tape to the back of this piece, and now I'm aligning my card base on my cutting mat using the grid lines to make sure I have everything centered. I'm going to add some foam tape on top of the sentiment strip only to the non-stamped part and adhere my doily. I'm using foam adhesive here to create a bit of dimension on my project and to help the die-cut pieces to stand out from the background. I'm going to add the large flower in the same way, and I'm placing it in between the small gold flowers there on the doily. Next, shape the die-cut and embossed leaves and insert them under the doily to balance out the design. Use glue to adhere those in place. To add some string to our project, use Spellbinder's celebration thread, wrap it around the card, and tie into a bow on the front. Finally, embellish your project with a few gold gems. Place one in the center of the large flower and two just under the thread on the right to finish this card. So here's one final look at this simple Love You, Always Have, Always Will project created using Spellbinder's Sapphire die cutting and embossing machine and Hearts and Flowers dies. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments section below. And be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more educational and inspirational videos. Thanks for watching. Bye!